Good afternoon to all. So one of the most awaited moment is here today, a valedictory function. I'm extremely happy and proud to be a part of this batch. This program is a culmination of our journey in UNLAB. Yes, I can see the excitement and thrill with which you are waiting for the function to begin. I am also excited. But let me first take this opportunity to welcome the guests of honor, trustees, staff, faculty members, and other invitees for the 91st batch valedictory function this afternoon. I have great pleasure in welcoming the guests of honor who have spared their precious time for us this afternoon. I welcome Mr. Vinamra Srivastav, CEO, Capital Land, India.
Thank you. Is it so? Why are they coming to our country? Are they coming to fight with Bijapur? We shall send them to find out what is that. We should send the ambassador to find what is that.
But how can you stop them? How can you tell them? They are migrating, they are waving a white flag.
That means they are not coming to fight with us. They are asking for help.
It looks as though they are migrating from their country. What do we do, Your Highness?
Our country is already overpopulated. We shall send them a pot of milk and to show that our country is already overpopulated. There is no place in our country to accommodate them.
The king sends the ambassador, pot full of milk, to show them that they cannot accommodate them.
Has given the this pot of milk to show you that our country is full?
Yes, we do understand the symbolic way of saying this.
They think for some time. One of the migrants gives small cup of sugar and tells the ambassador,
"Please tell your king, though the pot is full of milk, the small cup of sugar can be easily dissolved in the milk and make the milk sweeter, which adds value to the milk. So also we will add value to your country by our presence.
If given shelter in your country, we will be always be truthful, useful and grateful to you. We will be contributing our maximum for the development of this country, not only for this generation but for future generations also."
The king was impressed and touched by this, allowed them to stay in his kingdom.
"We promise to be ever grateful to this country and we will never forget this help rendered to us by you all.
Let us accept them."
The king accepts them. This is not just a story. It's the real story of the Parsis. The migrants were the Parsis who migrated from Iran and Afghanistan due to persecution some 300 years ago. They rendered great service to our country. The Tata Group of Companies was started by Sri Jamshedji Tata.
"We promise to part with one and of our country for your welfare of our country India for the citizens."
Now children, what do you learn from this?
When we joined Unnati, we were like part of milk, but Unnati added sugar in our thoughts, thus making useful and valuable.
Children, now tell me, when a few people can do so much for our country, we have benefited many things from Unnati, haven't you all?
Yes, ma'am.
What is that we can do for Unnati?
Ma'am, I will source as many students as possible for each bachelor.
I will try to contribute to Unnati money so that my brothers and sisters can get training at Unnati like us.
Make it practicing by different things, good things. So I will refer few students to Unnati.
Learn and stand tall.
Thank you.
My name is Sapa Devan.
My name is Bhil Madhu.
My name is Purushottam Reddy.
I am Krishna.
I am Mumta.
I am Veronica.
I am Malikarjun.
My name is Subin.
My name is Naveen.
I am Jasmine.
I am Jyoti.
I am Satya.
I am Rohan.
Dance is one of the expressions of emotions, feelings through the movement and manipulation of the body through choreography. Now, our friends are going to present to you. Here we go.
I would like to share about the training program in
change my life. I am more confident to speak in front of you today. I am more confident and communication with you. I am handling different situations, whatever comes in my life, I am easily handled to that. I am now adjust to the all situations and many problems, how it can be solved in my life. I really understand actually. I am thanking the all Unnati teams for this wonderful training program. Thank you all.
Thank you, Subin. Now I call upon Mamta to share her experience.
Good afternoon, respected guests, faculty members, and my dear friends. I am Mamta. I come from Baleswar district, Odisha. Here, my profession is business associate. Now, I am sharing the changes in my life after coming Unnati. I didn't able to communicate in English to others. I have very fear to come on stage, see the audience. I was a shy girl. Now I am able to communicate in English. Whatever you told, I am speak in English. Before I don't know how to speak English. Now I improve my communication and skills. This is my first step our life in front of audience. Now I overcome my shyness and fear also. Big example, I stand here without fear. Vocational training many places will be getting, but this is the right platform for everyone, because everyone has educated but not being a getting employee. Unnati is the platform for us. I really miss you, Unnati, and faculty members. I am improve my gratitude to Unnati, and I improve my skills also. I am confident I can get a job here. Thank you all. I miss you, Unnati. Thank you.
Good afternoon to all. My name is Madhu. I come from Kannur, Andhra Pradesh. Today my year of my vocation is business association. Today I would like to share my personal experience at Unnati. I learned here so many things. Let me share my few things what I have learned here. I learned here how to face problems in right way, whatever comes in my life. And how to manage our money in effective manner. And I really like to the way of teaching Unnati. They're teaching us whatever they're teaching us in class. They're conducting group activities. In that group activities, we are each to one talk together very politely. It is very useful to communicate to each other. And comes to my stage, I'm in love here. Overcome my stage fear. Every day we have morning assembly topic. In that assembly topic, they give to us a new topic. In that new topic, I never give up. Whatever comes to me, I take initiative and speak something, whatever I know, my experience. That is make to speak something in front of you. That is make me like that. And I really gratitude to Unnati, and thank you for giving me such a valuable opportunity.
Thank you, Madhu. Now I call upon Rohan to share his experience.
Hi friends, good afternoon. My name is Rohan. I come from Gadag district, Alkeri. It is a small village of in Karnataka. It is small village. I would like to talk about 50 golden days of Unnati. Unnati is not a just a skill center. It is a brand. I share to brand. It's produce brand product like us, we have to in first days I one of the laziest person. Now I am an active person because I proudly say to Unnati talk to me like us, and now I know value of food, value of time, value of function, value of money and value of work. Unnati taught me these are things, and in Unnati I like lot of all classes, but my favorite class is value class and life skills class. And I have never forgotten that girl name Shilpa Nagar. She referred to Unnati. Thank you.
Now I call upon Sukanya to share her experience.
I am Sukanya. I am from Chandrachet, Bangalore. My vocation is retail associate. I feel happy that Unnati has given excellent quality to my life and my career. I enjoyed every moment in Unnati. I enjoyed every moment in Unnati and every classes and every sessions. Each second I learned something good to my life. In our hostel, every Saturday Sunday there was a life skill classes, but I never attend the classes. I tried to escape from there. After coming to Unnati, I attend each classes and I love it. Coming to my family background, my father was very loved to be and he shows affection to me. I never believe it. One of our faculty told that always your parents gave you, year after you have to care them. I have changed my life and started to care my parents. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sukanya. Now I call upon Kausalya to share her experience.
My name is Kausalya. I come from Tamil Nadu. My vocation, retail associate. Coming to Unnati, so learn communication, then not food waste, then regularly respect. So all I miss them Unnati, but I love my Unnati. So thank you for Unnati.
Now I call upon Sakadevan to share his experience.
Good evening to all. My name is Sakadevan. My vocation is BA. I am come from Tamil Nadu. Tharoor district. Now I am going to my Unnati experience. Before I studied AME, aircraft maintenance engineering. But I completed that course, but now I am not getting job because one reason. That one is I am not learning the English, not communication, science also is there. That only reason. Then what I am doing, I don't know. I always, my mind is perturbing. So I am staying only home down. So my family also fall. Then after, my mom is calling. You don't know, you please come to Bangalore. You support the more than person is there and the job is there. You come and Bangalore, you learn English daily, you can go to any center. Now, before 1 month, I will come to in Bangalore, refer to my relations, some relations, Krishna boy, Amma. That mama is, you come, you can go and join Unnati, you can more than you can learn English, that good learning, that center is, you can go, opportunity is there, you can leave it, you can never give up. You can go and join to Unnati, that mama is telling. After I will come to Unnati, I learn English development and I don't know how to use the computer and typings, not that. But here come to Unnati, I typing to speak for more than speed and computer also. Before little bit I know, but here I completed. Excel, PowerPoint, this not there before, but here yes, I know. Then respect. First of all, respect. So I learning the respect. Before I only for respect my family only, but now all our friends and everyone I respect. First of all, respect now. That one. Then life skills. Life skills is most important. I learn it here only, lot of things. Communications and my strength. I know here only come to my strength, how do you know? I know. More than punctuality. Punctual is learning and how to attend the interview. Here only I learning. Before I going to more than interview, I all you can go out that my person is telling. But here come to I learning more than skills. So I lot of thanks to Unnati. All are come to Unnati. You learn English and more than skills. Please come Unnati. You can get job. Thank you.
Good afternoon everyone, my name is Malik Arjun, I come from Bangalore, my profession is business associate and now I am talking about 50 days wonderful journey in Unnati, what I can learn here. When I was came here in last 2 days I was attending our class, but it's getting bored first day because I am not interested to any activities. Anything, any assembly in that time. I want to go back home. I have to decide it in that time. Decided, and then in third day and fourth day, I have to interest to get into activities in that time. And I am mingled to my friends. It's good for me. I am feeling better. Why should I go? It's coming for a. Why should I come here? Now why should I going back? I know that everything. I know. I can speak in that time when I was participating in all activities, in mingled to everyone, I decided I have to stay here. And then one day I in our class everyone doing a mistake. So in that time, our man kept our mobiles, everyone mobiles. In this generation, we can't live without internet, any mobile phone. We can't live. When our man kept our phone in that time, we are all some of them are friends crying. Three people are crying. How can we live? I can't live. We have decided. Without phone, I can't live. We already decided. In that time, everyone went to hostel and first of all, we have phone. In that time, finishing our session in 8 o'clock, in going to everyone going and coming to in only for everyone doing open mobile and doing Facebook, WhatsApp, everything. No one can chat with us. In that time, no. Only he was saying when he was get bored, good night. Only that what everyone was saying in that time. When man was kept one day in mobile, everyone came to group and expressed their feelings. Telling each other, hey, you don't know, we can enjoy next same is gone. Everyone say good night. It's one of the good experience for here. And you know, one of the main I never leave without family. And one of my first time to live in hostel also. It's good experience for us. It's give confidence and freedom for us. And I sacrificed my mother in 15 days. Sorry, Narayan sir, you have to talk for me. Call for your mother. Everyone told. Call for mother and ask her how is she. But I have to tell you in that time lie. But honestly, I have to accept it. But in 15 days, I can't call in my mother, even also. Now I have to decide it. When I go back home, I will confidently talk in English with my mother. Hi, mother. And thanks to Alok sir, who refers for me, and thanks to Unati. One second.
Thank you, Malikaji. Now I call Veronica to share her experience.
My name is Veronica. I come from Kolar district, Karnataka. My occasion is retail associate. I feel very happy that Unati has provide a very good parity and skill plus. This is not only for 50 days training, this is for throughout our future also. And I'm very happy that, I feel happy that I don't know the value of food, but when one of my faculty said about food, from that day I'm not testing my food and I'm giving respect to all, and I don't have any confidence before, but when I learn about skills, when I enjoyed many classes, and I am I have no self-confidence. I improved myself more, and I can face with strangers how to speak. Thank you.
Thank you, Arunika. Now I call Mohan to share his.
Good evening for Mahana, good evening to Mahana. My name is Mohan Kumar and my vocation is BA, Business Associate. And I would like to share my personal experience in Unnati in 50 days training. After joining Unnati, I would very first or second person I would like to life skill classes or values classes. I would like, but it's very important for in my life also. Everything, everyone was learn life skills, because whatever you become, if you want life skill and if you know about life skill and values, that time only you become achieved. If any habit and any work, if you adapt your life, If you can, when 21 days, you will learn. You will every day 21 days you will do that work, then that time will be you will compulsory will achieve that work. That's why Unnati was providing 50 days training. Is the 20 days more than 50 days? That's why we will compulsory everyone achieve and learn something new and values, respect and sportive determination. It's important in my life also. That's why you have to learn life skill. Life skill is very important. I learn myself also. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. Thank
you. Thank you, Mohan. Now I call upon Jyoti to share her experience.
My name is Jyoti and I am from Bangalore, and I am going to tell about my experience, how I spent it whole 50 days. It was very nice because I had changed lot of things. When I was in hostel, I used to sleep so many times and I was become lazy. And I was thinking I can't able to do anything. And I came here. Unnati has given me everything. You can do it. And I being functioning and getting my more talents outside. Unnati has showing the talents for me. You can do it and you can achieve anything. But I think Unnati is a role model for me. And who has referred me? I came from organization. One of my faculty, Shaini ma'am, she has referred me, and I am going to tell special thanks for her because of her, I learned something in Unnati, and it's very nice. And I will be enjoying my classes, all those things. It will be very nice, and my friends will be. They will be encouraging me, you can do it. And I have the fear to speak in front of you. But now also I have little bit, but I am speaking. Still I am speaking because Unnati is encouraging me. And I learned everything. I know the value of food. I was wasting food in my hostel. They used to scold me, you won't eat food, you wasting, so many people are not getting food. I was doing again and again that only. Because the other words, we won't listen. We think, whatever we think, we will do that only. Mm-hmm. And in that class, in this class, I learned what is the value of food. And I learned life skills. I changed my emotions. I'm very innocent. If somebody scold me, I will start cry there only. Now I come little bit, and I have that one day assembly was going. I came late. Chaitanya ma'am has asked, why are you late? And I told ma'am. It was very cold. For that only I didn't wake up late. Sorry, for that only I wake up late. I thought that still I am there. I can sleep. And I was doing. My friends was Jyoti, get up. You have classes. Go. And I said, hey, still time is there. You getting so soon and you going nothing. I was sleeping. I'm too lazy. But after Unnati, I changed little bit. That I have more confidence that I'm managing times also, and I used to waste monies. Whenever money with me hand, I will if while going road, I will see something and I will buy that suddenly. And after money, and I will think, oh, I finished. it's very important, money is very important, but that time I can't get money. So here they taught me value of money, how to manage the money, and thank you for Unnati, and they have changed me a lot of. In my hostel they was changed. I do for a few days and I will do same thing. Unnati has given that. So I'm thanks for Unnati. I will be thankful for Unnati, and I am going to refer each batch students, and I will tell about Unnati some few things, good things for people, and I will bring students for Unnati. So really, so thanks. I don't know what to speak, but
now, will you go back and change again, or you will remain like this?
Because I changed.
Very good. Thank you.
Thank you, Jyoti. Now I call upon Jasmine to share her experience.
Good afternoon to all. I'm Jasmine. I am from Kolmogra, Bangalore. My occasion is business associate. Now I want to share my experience at Unnati. Each and every day I learn many things, the value of tolerance, patience and trust. Even though I completed my BCom, I was lacking confidence that I will get a job. Now I am confident that I will get a job and I can face any interview. Before I used to, I'm not respecting my parents. Now I changed my attitude towards my parents and I'm respecting Unnati. Unnati have changed me from weakness to strength, from nothing to something. The knowledge they have imparted me is a great asset towards my throughout my life. Then trainers are inspired and motivated us during difficult times when we needed the words of encouragement. Then I thank who referred me, Dr. Tara Chako, who referred me to join here. And I have overcome from stage fear. I won't talk before anyone, but I am anchoring now. I am standing in front of here because of the trainers only. And I thank my mom also who supported me to do my course here. Thank you very
much. Thank you, Jasmine, and thank you for all of this. Now I call upon all my friends too on the stage.
It's only after we stepped out of our comfort zone that we began to change, grow and transform. We at Unnati start our day by chanting this affirmation, which gives us the energy and positive vibes. Today, we feel extremely delighted to chant the same in the presence of you all.
I am smart because I learn something new and good every day. You are smart because you learn something new and good every day. We are smart because we learn something new and good every day. I like myself because I take actions to make things happen. You like yourself because you take actions to make things happen. We like ourselves because we take actions to make things happen. I am perfect because I never ever make mistakes on me. You are perfect because you never ever make mistakes on me. We are perfect because we never ever make mistakes only. I am happy because I choose to be happy. You are happy because you choose to be happy. We are happy because we choose to be happy.
I now request the guests of honor to come and share their thoughts.
Good evening, all of you all, and very special guests on Dash. We have, I think, Steiner Priya, who teaches retail to the students. She got married recently. Her husband is in Kerala, and she's continuing here. So she's been asking us to be, you know, she be relieved to go to Kerala and join her husband. It may happen soon, so I request her to come on stage and say a few words. Please come.
Trustees, management team, faculties, and my dear students. I'm Priya. I have been associated with Unnati from past 4 years as a retail trainer in this organization. Yeah, as everybody says, even I too feel to be proud to be a part of this Unnati. I take this opportunity to thank everyone for giving me this to share my views on this 91st. Validation program. It's very difficult to say that shortly I'll be moving to Kerala, so where I would like to extend my future in the next step career ahead, and it's nothing much. Everybody says so this is 50 days of training program, so where it's not only our youth gets transformed, or also people like us, even people like us gets transformed. So I would suggest dear students to take up the jobs, whatever the jobs you get. Do not deviate your mindset, stay focused towards your goal, and take up whatever job that you would like to. At least work in a company for a minimum about 1 or 2 years. So the Unnati is not only for difficult time comes in everybody's life, but Unnati is only helping hand for everyone. I would like to add one quote, that is, people may listen to your words, but they feel your attitude. If you cannot do great things, at least do a small thing in a great way. So I wish you all the very best for the successful career ahead, and please do refer students to Unnati. And I once again ask of Ramesh sir for giving me this wonderful opportunity to share my views on this program. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Stana. All the best to you. Firstly, I must say that this program was very, very, you know, it is different in many ways. A lot of humor, you all are great actors, and the humor with which you presented, especially some people like Mallikarjun and Mamta, and so you have made us laugh. You brought a smile on our face, apart from feeling that, you know, it's a great energy which we could see in all of you. All the very best. It so happened that we had this function a week earlier because we were expecting some very important guests from Singapore, from Capital Land and Ascendas. So the placements are not open yet. Otherwise, it would have been over, and they would have told you which company they have joined. One of the things definitely I would like to share is we take this opportunity to thank the entire team of Unnati, the faculty, right from the admin staff to the security, because you heard a lot of people talk about respect in there. And I think if we are able to carry that aspect of mutual respect in our lives, our lives will be a much more happier feeling, and the respect you will earn, whether it is in your job or amongst friends, will be very special. So do carry those wonderful thoughts when you actually practice. We have a very special group of people today, and we have the HR of Azendas and Capital Lands, Ms. Suma, with us. So I start with her. What is her feeling? Whether, you know, what does she look at? Because people like a lot of companies come and talk and all that, but here is a lady who's heading HR, and I'm sure she'll be able to add huge value to, because next week you're going for interviews. May I request Suma to come and share her thoughts? Please come.
First of all, I feel very honored to be part of this whole program, and I'm thankful to Capital Land because I got this opportunity because I'm part of Capital Land. So I was hired by Vinabra, so thank you, Vinabra. So I feel exactly the same what you guys have been going through when you were standing on the stage. Butterflies are in my stomach as well even today, at this moment. In my college days or school days, I'm from a village and I studied in a Malayalam medium school throughout, including my college. And I used to feel the same thing that, you know, I don't know English because English is so, knowing English is supposed to be the biggest thing. During those days, and I'm sure, you know, whatever you guys were also presenting, it's still the same. But my viewpoint is that as long as you are able to communicate, and English is not our mother tongue, right? It's not our mother tongue, and India is like a, you know, such a big diverse country. We have different languages, and it's okay as long as you're able to communicate, as long as you're able to speak your own language. And if you have the right attitude, I think that is the key to success. You know, never give up attitude. Learn something new every day. Keep upskilling yourself. And more than the knowledge, we look at the attitude. Because people are competent some way or the other. Each of us have our own strengths. But the most important factor that we look at when we select people to be part of our organization, not just Capital Land alone, but any organization, we look at the attitude of the people, the students. Are they willing to do their best? Are they ready to learn something and then, you know, do their best, contribute to the organization? We used to go for campus interviews, campus selections, and some of those arrogant students used to stand up and ask, how much are you going to pay us? And I used to say that, you know, probably we are not willing to hire you because that's not what we are looking at. So my sincere request to all of you, don't just look at, I know money is very important, but don't look at the money, what you are going to get immediately, but look at the opportunity, the learning opportunity that you would be getting so that you can upskill yourself. And today everything is changing every moment. So you should be open enough to, you know, keep on learning, adapt yourself to the changing environment and be relevant. Always focus on how can I make my own brand, my own personal brand. And I keep telling this to my own people, my own team members, as well as the people that I am responsible for, that, you know, make your own mark. Whatever it is that you are doing, even if a sweeper sweeping the places, you know, he can make his own mark by doing his best way. So this is something that we look at every candidate. And I just want to say one thing. When I was called on to the dais, I felt I'm too small to sit on the dais because the faculty sitting in front of me, I think you're doing a great job, and what I'm doing, I think compared to what you've been doing is nothing. So I feel very small, you know, sitting on the dais, and I would like to actually thank the faculties and whoever is running this, you know, great place, Unnati, because you are transforming the lives of so many people, not just the individuals sitting here, but their families. And they have a great influence on the society, whatever organizations or whatever place they are going to be working in. I think they will transform those or influence those places as well, because you are teaching values more than anything. I think I was reading a book, I'm still reading that, The Transcendence, written by Dr. Kalam and Arun. Tiwari, and it says, you know, without a moral society, the country cannot grow. And I think what you all of you are teaching the students here, or whoever is becoming part of Unnati, it's a great deal. And I think you're directly contributing to building a great nation ahead. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Suman. We really appreciate the sharpness with which you are able to identify that aspect of values, because I think what Unnati does is only talk about values. And we feel that if we can bring in values into the whole aspect of our life, their attitude will change. Automatically they will get employed, and then it's easy. So we don't look at training as a skill part or knowledge transfer, but more to change the human being, and which is a permanent change. That's the whole approach. Thank you very much for highlighting it. It's a very serious course, because it's 8 o'clock in the morning to 7-8 in the evening on a daily basis. And I was very happy to hear about the mobile thing, because that is the problem today in every household. So it's not just in Unnati hostel or Unnati, it is a problem across the board. So I think we should have a new rule brought in: any student joining Unnati must not have a mobile, and then we'll have an empty chair. But then we'll not have students coming, they will not join. But that's the whole program. It's almost 8 to 8 in the evening, and our only test for ourselves is if at 6 o'clock we walk into the class and the energy levels in the class is not good, we feel responsible. So if at 6 o'clock the energy level of our students is not good, then we have not done a good job. Then we have failed. Right? So that's the way we take responsibility. That is why this transformation happens. And we have a very enviable record of 100% placement across the board, across all centers. And that is something which we will never compromise. Because that is the commitment what we have for ourselves. You know, it is important. I'm sharing this because you are part of the HR and you understand these nuances better. We are extremely grateful to Ascendas, Capital Land, for being part of Unnati, and you know, we have Anshu here, Arun here, Ram here, all of them from the wonderful organization. We are expanding with them in Tamil Nadu also. We are extremely grateful. You are one of the biggest donors for us, with almost six centers being sponsored totally and all that, growing. So we are really grateful, and thank you very much for all your support. Another organization which really has been part of Unnati is Tesco, and we have today with us not just Karuna, we have Bhadevi also here. I request to come on stage, and she on the mic. She is from the finance analytics and all that. She joined them recently, 3 months back. But I was surprised that before she came and she had done a lot of homework. She knew about the program. So really appreciate it. Thank you. Please come. Probably the analytics is new. That's that.
Good evening. I'm really overwhelmed to be here. To start with, I would really congratulate all the Unnati students who completed the course. A great definitely, taking that ownership of I want to do something in life, I want to change the way I am, it's very difficult. And I'm sure since you guys are here, you've made that decision that I want my life to be different. And I hope that it's not just this 50 days, Unnati. You will continue doing that in all your fields of life and you'll never forget it. That's really a great achievement if you can really continue everywhere. And I also really thank myself that this is such an awesome organization to start. I read about him and I'm really glad that I could meet him today. I'll definitely take a lot of notes from him later in the class. And all the faculty, I was talking to a few of the faculty who left the corporate career and then joined this organization. It's really a great decision of what they want in life, because it's not easy that you pause from your regular career and then do society related whatever improvement we want to do. It's really great. I really thank all the faculty. A few things which I could relate to my own self. So I came from a very simple family. It's only my mother, because of her I'm here, because I lost my father when I was very young. If it was not her, I wouldn't be here today talking to you guys. So she put a lot of effort in upbringing myself and my sister. So it's parents who are always the standing stone for all of us, and I'm glad that because of Unnati, when I heard few of the students saying that now I respect my parents a lot, I am glad you guys have changed, because parents are really very important in our life. Thanks a lot to Unnati to teach the values, and I hope you all continue that and support your parents throughout your life. Secondly, I would also go with the value of money. When I was young, frankly, I never been to any movie, no parties, no friends outing and all those things. I felt, did I miss my childhood or a teenage? But then when I look back now, I felt no, I was more focused in what I want in my life. So what sacrifices I made then, trying to focus on my education, trying to focus on my career, has paid now. Now I have the liberty to do what I missed then. But if I would have concentrated on those things at then, now I wouldn't have the a liberty or the money to do now. So what you spend or in your career in the early years makes a lot of difference. So you guys are starting your career now. So it's very important that a focus on career initially pays a lot. So the more you want to learn, that enthusiasm, that curiosity which Unnati has taught all of you, the more you continue with that in your career, the more you will grow. So that's something which I always have constant, even today, I will never settle for less. In a sense, what I say, if you are given a task, a work in your organization, wherever you are, don't say, okay, this is my work, I'm done with it. No. The more you think, okay, this is what I'm doing, can I do something different? Can I add more value to it? Can I look at it in a different way? If you're doing it 1, 2, 3 steps, but if I do it in 1, 2 steps and you're happy about it, that's how you need to keep thinking. Can I add more value? Can I do something different? The more you try to imbibe the culture of doing things differently, learning something new, being more curious is very important. Second, and for me it's very most important, is asking for help. When I'm not there, I can't do something, I just don't want to sit in a cocoon. I go to someone to raise my hand and say, I need help. So that's really important for all of us. Even today, if I feel that I think you guys are all learning that failure is a stepping stone to success. So if you feel you're going to fail, or even if you fail, don't shy away and then ask for help. I think Unnati is always there with all of you to help. But if not Unnati, in any organization you go, in anywhere you're going in your life, ask for help. In an organization, it could be your manager or it could be the HR, the best person to reach out for help. So just always remember that. Ask for the help. And the third is definitely in terms of mistakes, learning from mistakes. So we all do mistakes, but then don't hide mistakes. In any company, no one will encourage that you hide mistakes. So even if it's a mistake, accept it and say, I did this, people will understand or say okay, but then also learn from our mistakes. Even we all are human beings, we will always do mistakes, but being brave, having that courage to accept the mistake is very important. And then learning from it is even more important, that you don't repeat the same mistakes. So these are the few key things which I always follow in my life, even till date. I'll be glad if you guys also remember and try to follow them and learn all the values, remember all the values which Unnati has given and practice them throughout your life. Thank you so much.
We cover, we were coming around 4,000, 5,000 youth. But what has happened is this UNEXT was a thought which came somewhere in 2017. We feel it's a very, very important program. We have not been able to cut ice with many organizations, but thanks to the voluntary effort and participation of the team, they have accepted UNEXT and they are supporting us. We go to government colleges and final years and drive a finishing school model of just 100 hours to English communication life skills writers. And this has helped us to scale. Last year we did over 10,000 youth across the country, and this year we are hoping to touch, yesterday we were reviewing, we are hoping to touch 15,000 youth. So that as a combination of of course our dream, our vision, our mission, everything is to touch a lakh of youth every year. And just to put in perspective the seriousness of the issue, in 1 year, 1,50,000 youth come out of government first grade colleges, BA, BCom, BSc, and ITIs. Karnataka alone. So you are talking of 14, 15 million across the country. And in Karnataka, out of 1,50,000 youth who passed out in May 2016, hardly 10,000 youth got a job. That's been the situation. And with our intervention, we have already started seeing more than 60-70% are getting into jobs and higher studies, and the whole change is happening. And we are the only organization in government in Karnataka which has been approved by the Directorate of Education to run this program. We are looking at how this can be scaled to an Akshay Patra level, where you are able to reach out to a lakh of youth and really make a difference across the state, and then probably replicate it into many other states. And one of the companies which has been supporting us is Tesco. Really grateful to you for doing that and taking it to the next level. Thanks a lot on that. We have today for the first time the CEO of Ascendas, Mr. Srivastava, is here. I call upon him to share his thoughts and
My name is Vinamra. I think all of you have made my job very easy, because whatever I wanted to say, you've already said. So thank you so much for that. But I still would like to summarize whatever I have learned and try to share that with you. Wait, where's Mamta? Show of hands. Mamta, where are you? Mamta, you talked about how you used to have fear. Sit down, please. You talked about how you used to have fear of the stage, right? And how you have tried to overcome that. And a lot of you felt that. The first time I went on stage was, I think, when I was 7 years old. And I had to read something from a piece of paper that was already with me. So all I had to do was come up, read it, go back. And you have these morning assemblies and you read the thought and the news and all. And I remember, this was the very first time, and I remember I came up and the whole school was there and I had the page, and I was shivering, so the page was going like this. And I just went blank. I couldn't speak a word. And then, like some of the faculty was goading you here, right? Say this, that's what my teachers are doing. No, say this. And I just couldn't, I could not see the piece of paper. It was just white. somehow I kind of managed to blabber out, I don't know what I managed to say. Right. So that was the first instance. The second instance was when I was probably 10, 11, and I started writing a diary in English for the first time, like your own journal, and you record what you did in the day. And my English was horrible. It was pathetic. So my brother, who's quite elder to me, used to always make fun of me. You know, he used to read my diary, and then he would make fun of me. That in every sentence you're making a mistake, you can't even write one sentence in English properly. Right? So that was the second instance. And then the third instance that happened in school was when I was a bit older, probably 13 or 14. And that was the first time I took part in a skit, like how you all perform the skit, right? So incidentally, I was in Bangalore that time, many years back. And I was playing, we have a mathematician called Bhaskaracharya, a very famous Indian mathematician. And we had a skit on his life history, so I was playing the young Bhaskaracharya. And that was the first time I had to speak in English without looking at a piece of paper on the stage. And we practiced for it for many, many months. I'm sure you would have practiced for your skit today. And then when my parents came to watch it in the annual day, my mother was just shocked. Her mouth was open and she said, "We never knew you can speak in English." Because at home we spoke in Hindi, my mother tongue is Hindi, so we spoke in Hindi. So she never knew I can speak English. And she said, all the time I was speaking on the stage, she was just praying. You know, he should not goof up. Because she had never heard me speak English. And then many years passed, and I worked at it. And then in 2013, I actually wrote my first book. And Penguin published that book. That I took that book to was my brother. And I told him, remember how many years back you said I cannot even write a sentence in English? Well, today I have a book that Penguin has published. And he told me that nobody in this world could be happier than him to see that. And today my job entails me speaking in front of sometimes thousands of people on the stage. And the only reason I could traverse this journey was because of three values. And I just wanted to share those three values with you. The first was absolute hard work and commitment. You know, Satya made a point. Where's Satya? Satya, raise your hand. Satya, you made a point on solving problems, solutions, and being dedicated and committed. So the first thing that I learned throughout my life and my career was that irrespective of whether things are going up for you or going down for you, what is most important is your commitment and your hard work and how focused you are in what you want to achieve. You all would have heard the saying when they say, God helps those who help themselves. So luck will only play a little bit of part. Luck can sometimes help you, luck will always not be there with you. You may have some support, which you're very fortunate to have through Unnati today. Tomorrow you may not have that support. There may be times your parents are with you, behind you. There will be times when you are all alone. Irrespective of what the situation in your life is, what's most important is how focused you are, how committed you are in what you want to achieve, and how hard you work at what you want to do. And throughout my own career, and I've seen that with many, many successful people around that I continue to engage with, that was one differentiator. That whatever happened in their lives, what did not change was the amount of hard work and commitment that they put in. Because once you do that, you will be able to go back and sleep in peace knowing that you have given your best. There's nothing more that you can do. If you can go to bed in the night with that thing in your heart, you will have the sweetest sleep ever. And you should try to make sure every day of your life allows you to feel that satisfaction. So hard work, no substitute to it. No other shortcut in life that will take you far apart from doing hard work. The lesson number two, and which a lot of my colleagues, all of you have shared as well, was on learning. And you all mentioned that as well, right? And Sakadev put it very nicely. Sakadev, where are you? You're a good dancer, by the way. Sakadev, you know what he talked about in terms of his Microsoft Excel and PowerPoint and all of the things that he did not know earlier. And he learned. So the attitude to learn, the hunger to learn and continue to grow irrespective of whether you are a 5-year-old or a 20-year-old or a 50-year-old or an 80-year-old, it does not matter. Whether you are starting your career, you are a manager, you are a CEO, you are a chairman, it doesn't matter. Whether you are poor, whether you are a billionaire, it doesn't matter. You all need to have that hunger to always keep learning. How many cricket fans here? Tendulkar fans? All the boys are raising their hands, right? Tendulkar's last day, and I keep sharing it with my organization, so you guys will know this example. Tendulkar's last day of cricket was this match against West Indies, a test match. Some of you may remember, at Wankhede in Mumbai, right? And he batted on that day. And even on that day, after playing cricket for 25 years, and being the best batsman in the world, in the morning he was out in the nets practicing, trying to learn. Why is he missing deliveries outside the off stump? How can he get better at that? Now the best batsman in the world also needs to learn and practice every day. And who are we? What have we achieved compared to the great people in the world like Tendulkar and Barack Obama or any person you take in their respective fields? The one thing common to all of them is their hunger to learn and the humility to acknowledge that they will never be perfect. There will always be things that you will not be good at and you need to keep learning and keep working, keep practicing, keep taking in new knowledge. As long as you have that attitude, it will take you far. So when Sumanya talked about it's attitude and not aptitude that matters, nothing can be more correct than that. When you go for interviews out there next week or whenever that date is, just remember, it is your attitude that will matter. And not just in these interviews, throughout your life, throughout your careers, if your attitude is positive, if your attitude is the one where you want to learn, together with the first point that I made on hard work, then you're going to have a very successful career and very successful life ahead of you. And the third and the last point that I would like you to remember is, again, which was something that was mentioned earlier, is about your attitude of never giving up in life. Never, ever. You will fall. Whatever your faculty may tell you today that things will be great if you do this, that, you will fall in your life. And I can bet that you will have situations where you feel that you have hit rock bottom. And what will test your character is how you come out of that. And that's called resilience. How you respond to adversity, how you respond to when things are not going your way. You know, Virat Kohli had a series in England where he barely made any runs. 5 matches, kept getting out. I don't know, some of you may have seen it. Just kept getting out again and again and again. Same, wicketkeeper catching, slips catching, never made any runs there. Right? And look what he where he is today. That, you know, I'm like the worst batsman in the world, nothing can happen, and he'll suck. He wouldn't have been there, but where he is today. Right? So how you respond when things are not going your way will determine how successful you will go ahead. So always be positive and never give up in life, no matter what people tell you. You will find people who will try to pull you down in life. That is a reality whether we like it or not. You will always have such people. You need to ignore them, cover your mind and stay focused and tell yourself that you are never going to give up, come what may. Even if the whole world gives up on you, even if your own parents may give up on you, you will never give up on yourself and you will always try hard. Adidas, you guys know about Adidas? You have heard Adidas? What is the logo of Adidas? Do you know? Anybody? What does it say? Adidas caption. It says, on your smartphone guys, just Google it later. It says, impossible is nothing. That's what you should always remember. And that's what your attitude should be. So work hard, keep learning, never give up in life, and I'm absolutely sure that all of you are going to touch the sky. I do want to thank all the faculty. You all have been absolutely fantastic and we are all really humbled. What we are doing in our lives is so minuscule to what you are doing because you are transforming lives here. And I really want to thank you and appreciate all of you. Have a great career ahead. Thank you so much for giving me this platform. Thank you.
That was really special, Mr. Ramana. And you mentioned about two things, one about English. I must say why we are so focused on English, and the reason is not just about the language. It's not about being accepted across the world, in the job market, in the growth phase. But the attitude what we bring in to they fear English the most in life. They have this feeling that English is impossible for me. You know, from the background which I come in. And we are able to break that barrier of fear and thought. In just 50 days, they start talking in English here. So apart from all the benefits of being able to talk in English, the most important thing which we as the organization feel is the fact that we have been able to bring in a change which says that anything is possible by me. Because if I could learn English which I thought is impossible in 50 days, in my life, I cracked it in 50 days. So it's a very, very important message which we are trying to give. And that's an effort which we definitely put. Second thing we have done is we have brought in an app called Playablo to learn English and gamified app. Now, many people will think that this app is to improve English. You know, many of my faculty also keep thinking that yes, this app has been introduced so that they can improve their English for the 50 days. The management decision and the thought process is slightly different. It's about continuous learning and introducing them into internet learning. Because as days progress, as years progress, you're not going to be having teachers like Kantimati teaching you, you know, in the classroom. You have to learn, and the internet is going to be the best teacher. If you are not tuned to learning through internet, you're going to be losing out. So it's more from that aspect that we have brought in this. And so talking about English, we have a very, very special person. Two, three things. She is a master trainer. She teaches English. She has worked a lot on the curriculum of Unnati English 2 with a lot of others. Second, she just completed 10 years of service with Unnati. Third, Kantimati celebrates her birthday today.
Good evening to all.
Good evening.
I'm really overwhelmed to be here today. It's all because of the trustees who have given me an opportunity to be here. And you students, without you, I will not be here in Unnati, right? So it is you who have made me great today. And I wish everyone does this great job by introducing more of your friends. I would like to tell a small story. I know that my students know the story, but still I would like to relate it to what we are going to talk to. There was a man who was very thirsty walking in a desert. And desert, you know, you don't get water. So he was looking out for water. Maybe he found a small bottle filled with water. And beside that, there was a boulder. And he wanted to open the bottle and wanted to drink the water. Then he saw a small board telling, use this water to fill the board. First pour the water in the borewell and start pumping. Now he was in a dilemma whether to pour the water in the borewell or whether he should drink, because he was very thirsty. And suppose if I pour the water and if I pump and if I don't get water, what am I supposed to do? So he, for a while he was just thinking, then it struck him. Okay, whatever may be, I will pour the water in the borewell. So he poured the water in the borewell. As we prime motors, if it doesn't start, we prime the motor so that it starts, right? So he poured the water and he started pumping. And he could drink not only one bottle of water, but as much as he could. So then he thought, wow, this works. So he again, he just wrote another line under the board saying that this works. So how do I relate this to you all? Moral of what? The moral is unnati, right? So the bottle of water is you guys, right? So you have to bring in more students so that they get trained and they learn more from us, right? If you all are not here, then we are nothing. And what work we are doing is just a dot in this whole world. So we want to bring more transformation in more students, and we want to see the transformation because you all are going to be the future leaders. And I thank the trustees. What I am today, yeah, from childhood I have learned. I have my father here and my grandmother. My grandmother brought me up saying, it is with society that we have to live. So society is the only person who is going to help us. So society, respect society, love society. I have learned it from her to give back to society. And my father always encouraged me to study, learn, study. You are not going to stop studying. He's 85, still he reads books. Any caption he sees, he just relates that to us whenever we go home to meet him. And I have him over here. I have learned to be great people around me, and I see in every person I see a positive attitude, and that is where I am standing today, right? And my mother, I have learned how to be patient from my mother. She's a very patient lady. Any problems she faces without tears in her eyes. She tells life is like this, we have to face it. And that is what we have learned. We are six children and I am the eldest. That is what they have taught me when I went to my in-laws place also. And I have a wonderful husband who is also here with me. Who has accepted me as I am. And he always encourages me. I will never find a man who is so patient as my husband. He really does a lot of help for me. 3 years back, when I was very sick, all my friends know that, he and my son, they have helped me come out. My parents, my husband and my son, they have brought me back. And Unnati also has given me the support to come back and serve. I was out of office for nearly 6 to 7 months. But they called me back and I'm here. And then, last but not the least, I have my son who encourages me in whatever I do. The whole family was telling, Mommy, please don't go back to office. Take rest and be in the house. He was the only person who told me, go back, Mommy. That's giving you happiness. Go back. Start working. And that gives you happiness, you will be healthy after going there. And I am here. I am really proud of all the people around me and my friends. They really came back to me telling, no Kanti, you are going to be back. You have to come to Unnati, Unnati needs you. And people like Charu, Girija, Alpa, Viji, all my teammates. I have a wonderful team working with me and that is how I am standing straight and steady over here. I thank all of you and students. Please bring back students for Unnati to grow. Not only in Bangalore, not only in Karnataka, but throughout the world. Wish you all the best. Don't forget, whatever you have done. And all the students, yeah, even we learn lessons from you all. You all sometimes bring tears in our eyes when we see the transformation happen in you. Wish you all the best. And I thank Ramesh sir, Narayan sir, and all the trustees for giving me an opportunity to work with you all for 10 years. Thank you so much. I would like to give more of my service to Unnati. Thank you.
Thank you, come on stage, please. And all the guests of honor to be with us when we hand over this memento to Kanti in a minute.